you want to eat like vegetables, that's fine.
Yeah.
But I don't feel like vegetables really make me stuff, you know?
Yeah.
So I'm searching for something that can replace that. I do want to try. But like when I try like vegan food, I don't know, man. For me, you have to get used to it.
I think it's cool.
Oh, that's cool.
You wanna have a conversation with me?
I don't think I'm the right person.
Okay. Are you vegan?
Huh?
Are you vegan?
I'm vegan. I don't eat pork, but...
Oh, I have footage from the whole industry here.
My opinion? I do eat meat, but I really don't want to see blood. I don't want to see them suffer.
Yeah.
But I'm not at that level yet.
Oh, I see.
I'm not that far.
But are you aware that they are suffering?
I am aware that they're suffering.
Yeah. So do you think we need to consume animal products to survive?
You asked the question?
Yeah.
Do we need it? I don't know. But can I stop it? I don't know.
Yeah.
Do I want to stop it? I don't know. But as a human kind, should we let them suffer? No.
Okay.
So what is the right way?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Maybe not eating them is the right way?
Not eating, yeah, but I'm a bit chubby. I love meat.
Yeah.
How do I stop it? Like from here to there?
So let's say, let me ask you this. If I were to give you a step-by-step instruction on how to stop it, would that incentivize you to stop eating meat?
And the thing is, long day at work, you come home.
Yeah.
You want to get, at least I want to get full.
I'm going to get a bit closer for the microphone.
All right, okay. If you want to eat like vegetables, that's fine.
Yeah.
But I don't feel like vegetables really make me stuff, you know?
Yeah.
So I'm searching for something that can replace that. I do want to try, but like when I try like vegan food, I don't know, man. For me, you have to get used to it.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, it's a
and the process of getting used to it. That's so difficult, man. It's like changing your entire life. And I admire people who can do that, you know. But how do they do it?
Well, I would say it's a step-by-step process, right? It obviously seems difficult when you look at it from one perspective, being like, oh, that seems so difficult.
Yeah.
But if you take it to a step-by-step, it's not that difficult. Even if you take it all at once, it's not that difficult. It's more of a habitual change, isn't it? Because we as humans are creatures of habit. I'm sure you eat kind of the same things and you buy kind of the same things
same
in the supermarket,
things, yeah?
Right?
That's what you're used to.
Yeah, because that's what you're used to. So
difference is scary.
Exactly. Yeah. So then... I think the only difference is that, where do you live, by the way? Do you live here?
I'm local.
Yeah, I'm also living in Amsterdam. So if you know, in Albert Heijn, there's so many good options now as vegan products.
I, you know, when I go to like the supermarket,
yeah.
I just go to the aisles that I'm used to. And I don't look at the other aisles. Maybe there's a lot of good food over there.
Yeah, yeah.
But then when you buy it, what do you make from it?
Yeah, well, I think a lot of the... It depends also right on your budget, I would say, but nowadays, especially in Netherlands, it's so easy. There's, for any budget you can find, there's a solution for whatever you want to make, to eat. There's even like lazy options. I personally choose those a lot of the times, even if sometimes they're a bit more expensive. Well, there's a lot of vegan mock meats. Have you tried those? Sometimes some of them are fucking amazing. Vegan mock meats.
Vegan mock meats. What
yeah,
is that?
It's like they're vegan products,
yeah.
And they're made to resemble meat as much as possible, so that you know, people who like meat, they don't necessarily have to give up on that texture.
They put like beans in it, right?
Some of them are beans. A lot of them are soy based.
Yeah.
So yeah, and
I
they
can taste that. But
yeah, well, soy doesn't really have a particular taste, right? So it depends a lot of on the product that you're eating.
Sure,
yeah. But like, would you say that the difference in taste or the habitual change, which is, let's say there's a certain difficulty to it, would you say that is it more difficult for you to change that habit or for the animals that go through, you know, these slaughterhouses?
I think the main thing is, you know, I really do feel sorry for them. But you know, to make a change like that, you have to get to know people who are like that.
Yeah.
And if you eat with people who are like that, you can find like alternative food.
Yeah.
And that's what I find is the most problematic way, is that I don't know which food to eat.
Okay,
but if you get in contact with somebody, for example, who has an entire lifestyle based on that and who isn't dead, you know,
yeah,
that's the
yeah.
main, I don't know if it's really reality, but people say like, people who are vegan,
I'm vegan and I'm thriving. It's fine.
Totally not kind of my thing. But okay.
Yeah. I'm vegan and I'm totally thriving on it, so it's no...
How long are you vegan?
I'm vegan for 2 years and I was vegetarian for 6 before.
Okay, so...
Yeah, but I have friends who have been vegan for like 20 years also. So.
Okay, then I have a question though.
Yeah.
For example, there are cows outside.
Yeah.
And in the Netherlands you have like open field cows.
Yeah.
And then whenever they feel like it, they can go to like the milker and they give their own milk away.
Yeah.
It's not forced.
Yeah.
It's just the cow wants to give it because they have enough and I guess they don't feel really good with it.
Yeah.
Do you eat like dairy products?
I don't eat dairy products, and I mean, the reason why I don't eat dairy products is not necessarily because of what you just said, but rather because of all the things surrounding it. Like, in order for a cow to get pregnant, in order for a cow to get milk, they have to be pregnant and have a child.
Yeah.
So, if the child is a male, they go to the slaughterhouse, they get killed in the first week of their life. So that already is one animal being killed. If the child is a female, they go through the same process as their mother. But what happens is that also after like 6 years of being artificially impregnated each year and trying to give milk each year, cows get so tired of it, of course, right? Because, you know, they forcibly impregnate them. They don't just...
But those are like farmhouses who force...
No, these are actually standard practices across all of them.
There are a lot of other places who do it like... They have a bull, and they have a herd of cows.
Yeah, but
they don't interfere.
Oh, that's not true though.
There is though.
No, but you know why? Because the milk...
Yeah.
The milk... Why do you think the cow makes milk?
Pardon?
Why do you think the cow makes milk?
To feed its child.
Exactly. So
what do you do with the excess?
Yeah, but the excess, you would say that there's a lot of excess, but the reality is that all of these farms, they want to make money.
Yeah.
For to them, the animals are nothing more but things that bring them money.
Okay.
So then, of course, they take away the child from the mother because it's the, you know, they want the mother, all the milk has to go for human consumption. Even if it's a small farm, the only way they can survive is by doing that.
Okay, then I have another follow-up question to understand.
Yeah.
Because if a cow's life is worth one,
yeah.
Do you like farm vegetables? Have you done that before?
No, not really, but I have farmed when I was young with my grandma and grandpa, yeah. Yeah.
How did you get away from all the insects and all the bugs who are eating your farm?
I mean, obviously there is some pesticide being thrown in there.
What about their lives?
Yeah, but their lives matter.
Is there an alternative so that they don't die either?
Well, there are alternatives to that, yes. But let's just put it this way. All of those deaths are also happening in the animal industry because the cows that produce milk, they're not only fed grass. I mean, there's very, like 5% of cows are fed grass. Mm-hmm.
Hello, I'm gonna interrupt the video for a bit because I feel I need to correct this. I got the 5% from this university website that was claiming that 4% of US beef retail and food services sales is comprised by grass-fed beef. But I'm not satisfied with this statistic, and besides, I live in the Netherlands, so I wanna know what happens here. I got this from the Dutch Dairy Association. They claim that cows are fed 75% grass, 25% corn, and a concentrate of other vitamins and vegetables. I would assume that this is the ideal, so let's compare to this. Based on this graph, a cow will eat about 14 kilograms of corn per day. From the concentrate, it appears that only 20% is inedible by humans, so 4 kilograms of that is farmed. That means that per day, a cow will have about 18 kilograms of farmed grain or vegetables. I will assume that a normal human being will eat 1, maybe 2 kilograms of that, keeping in mind that it's uncooked grains and vegetables, so they weigh less. That means that to grow a cow for milk, almost 10 times more crops are needed. That means that when you're eating meat, you kill 10 times more animals. Of course, there's more to be said, like how that is the ideal and the reality is different. Or how people that eat meat don't only eat animal products. But I made a whole video about this a while ago. Maybe go check that out. Now, back to the video.
But most of the cows are fed like corn, soy.
Yeah.
So all of those also have to be grown for them. And when those are grown, the same thing happens.
Same thing.
Yeah. So I would say that if everybody was plant-based, I would be here sitting and talking about a better way to farm vegetables. I agree with you. It's not perfect, but it is better, right, than just eating animals, right? So along with the animal that dies for the food itself, there's also the animals that die for the food of the animal. So there's a lot more deaths involved in...
But if you go into that side, you
know,
but that's like...
Yeah, but that's what you have to do. You have to try to be as objective as you can with this, right?
We save all or we don't save any. Is that the policy at the moment?
Well, no, the policy is exactly this, minimizing harm as much as you possibly can, right? Because if you think about it, even on a vegan diet, as you say, right, when they farm vegetables, some animals might be harmed in the in that process. And it's far from perfect, but it's better than having extra animals being harmed, right? Because do you think we need to consume? I mean, I ask you, we don't need to consume animal products to survive, right?
And I just want something to consume that makes me alive.
Yeah, exactly.
That lets me stay alive.
Exactly, exactly. So,
but then people have, like, society has to come up with a solution. Like,
but what would you say if I told you that being vegan is a solution to this?
But it isn't, though, because you're still like harming insects and bugs.
But if you
other things around it.
Okay, but then
you don't want birds eating your things.
But if you would, if you, you know, like all across the world, regardless of what you do as a entity on living in this world, you will inherently cause some harm, right?
Yeah.
Don't you think you have a duty to minimize that harm? Because if you don't, then you can easily just go on the street and say, I will just kill another person because anyway, my birth, what the products that I bought have inherently led to other people or other creatures dying. So therefore, one more life doesn't really matter, but it does, doesn't it?
It surely does, yeah.
Yeah, so it's about minimizing
the harm.
I don't
really agree about killing people because every day outside we kind of show our ego to other people.
Yeah.
So they don't interfere with us. We scare everybody away.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it's a good thought.
Let me give you a card. Let me give you a card because I want you to know more about this, and it seems like you obviously care about it. And
I care, but you know you have to process.
Yeah. So let me show you exactly what I mean. So,
what is card about?
So this card, if you go to this website that right here, you can even take a photo if you don't want to take the card.
Yeah, sure. Much better, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, because a lot of people they lose the card or they.
Change my screen.
Nice. So if you go to this website, it's called Three Movies That
We
the Free. It's from the organization that I sometimes do activism with. If you go there, it's a URL. If you go there, you'll find resources on how to be vegan. You'll find.
It's like a guiding website.
It's a website.
Do they have recipes?
It's a website. Yes, it's a website to help you be vegan, as vegan as you can. So, first of all, you have information about the whole animal industry, and if you have any questions or anything like that, you will see that all of them are answers. There's a it's a documentary called Dominion. A lot of the footage that you see here is from that documentary itself, which was shot all around the world, and you can see that. There's also resources that will incentivize you to go vegan. Like speeches that explain exactly why it's important. But there's also a thing called Challenge 22, which if you subscribe to it, the reason why it's called Challenge 22 is because it takes 22 days for a person to change a habit.
21,
yeah, exactly. Yeah, so I didn't, by the way. I just found out when regarding to this one. So on that website, if you subscribe to it, for free, all of it is free. It sends you recipes every day on how to be vegan. It tells you what you need to supplement, and it gives you all the extra information that you need to go towards your vegan route.
Maybe that's what I need, yeah.
Yeah, and aside from that, there's also personalized help also on this website, which is free. And someone will log in to you with you online. I think it's on the Discord server. They log in with you online and they help you out if you need extra information, if you don't know how to supplement some of the things or anything. So it's, yeah.
You know what I see in your eyes?
What?
Most people who have like an interview and they record it, they want to get like best things out of it for the views and then take apart from the person who are they interviewing it. From you, I can see you really care. You really
I do.
You really want to share. That's what I see. That's what makes it so beautiful about this moment.
Thank you.
So I would definitely check out the website. I have a picture on my phone.
Nice.
And because I need guidance, right?
Yeah. That's good.
So
yeah.
This is a good way to maybe begin the process and to understand it a little bit more better. than what I do in my usual life.
That's awesome. Yeah. That's awesome.
Thank you, man.
What's your name, by the way?
My name is Altar.
Altar. Nice to meet you. Exactly. I'm Chip, by the way.
Chip?
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
A great name, man.
Yeah,
great name.
Thank you. Okay. So I'll just leave you with this.
I think it's more than enough.
Check the website. Yeah. Go there. Just remember that every time you eat, 3 times per day, one pays for this, one doesn't. That's the vegan option. So you can take your time as much as you want. Just keep in mind that the more time you do, the more animals die for you. And one person, you, turning vegan.
Don't say that, but that feels bad.
I'm sorry, I'm sorry. I don't mean to put pressure on you.
I just mean to get over it.
Yeah.
I can then share my stories on a good way to other people.
Listen, I'm here for the animals. Okay, so I will tell you all the things that I know, because I want you to understand the situation exactly as it is. And it's true that going vegan, even if you accomplish it in 1 year, is obviously better than not doing it at all. But also keep in mind that in 1 year, all animals will still die for you, right? And it's up to you whether you want that or not. And it's up to you, because, you know, as human beings, sometimes we need a little bit push. That's the reality. Sometimes we need a little bit of otherwise we get so
direction.
We need direction, we need a little bit push, otherwise we get used to this. So the reason why I'm telling you all this is to get this, so that you understand the reality of it, of your choices, right? And you get to make those choices, of course, right? It's up to you. And you turning vegan can save up to 100 animals per year, which, if you think about it, it's not nothing. 100 animals, it's
100 living beings, right?
Exactly, 100 living sentient beings.
Yeah, I believe they're sentient. Yeah.
Yeah.
Chip, well, thank you for this wonderful moment, man.
Yes, thank you.
Wish you luck on spreading the word.
Yes, thank you.
Hope you find other people who are ready to actually start this movement.
Thank you. Yeah, take a look at all of this and get more informed on this, okay? Yeah.